Ash! Ash!
Meant to do that. You both all right?
No, Dennis. We've both got Eddie.
That's all right, Payface. What he's trying to say is that we've both got... We've both got...
Both got what?
Oh, Curly, Payface, didn't you get the letter? The Beano Town cold is so contagious that you must stay home. And you, dog. Yes, you, dog. You aren't allowed here. Pieface, Curly, dog, you must all leave the school grounds this instant.
Yeah, I think I might be coming down with something.
Inside. Quiet! Quiet, class, quiet! No more chattering, everyone! Quiet! Quiet! Oh, looks like quite a few pupils have the cold.
Not I, Mrs. Creature. I'm perfectly well.
Walter, didn't you get the letter?
I don't have a cold, Mrs. Creature. I am 100% healthy.
Class, if James has 37 counters in his left hand and 92 counters in his right hand, how many hands does he have? Walter.
Jumping at the shape of the people. See a rainbow.
Good try, Walter. Next question. Dennis, what is the square root of a million times the square root of a billion?
Is it 9?
Oh, hopeless, Dennis. Hopeless.
Yeah, Dennis. Oh.
Walter, call me crazy, but I think you may be ill. I'm having your parents pick you up.
No, Walter. This could be the best school day ever.
Just a dessert for my lunch, Bren. How much?
Not many children in, so they're free today.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll only have 50 of them.
Oh, no. Headmaster's orders. One dessert per child.
But I'm the only...
Strict instructions. Want your dessert, then?
Sure. Can I have a spoon? Yeah. Actually, forget the spoon. Thank you.
Bonjour. I am le French exchange student de Pierre Le Bonbon. La dessert, please.
All right, but you only get one.
Merci.
Hang on.
Oh, guten hello. I am German exchange student Fritz von Munich. Dessert, please, thank you.
Are there many kids in that lunch line?
Oh, sure. Why don't you take a look?
I knew it! You're not getting one over on me!
Oh, may have overdone it on dessert.
Come on, bowler! Right, batsman, hit it! Atta boy! Fielder, catch it! Well done for getting him out, Dennis. Marvellous play. Dennis, how come you're out already? Awful. Two laps round the field for you.
Well, Dennis, poor Walter had to go home.
Yes!
Which means for the rest of the day, it's just you and me.
No!
Only kidding.
Phew.
Since all the other children have the cold, you're going to spend the rest of the day being taught by all the teachers in the school. At once.
What?
What's 9 times 99?
It's long and stiff.
What's the meaning of life?
What is this, a square?
Oh, the worst day ever, Gnasher. Teachers, teachers everywhere. It's not fair. Why can't I catch a cold like everyone else? Actually, I think I can. Oh, the light, it grows faint. Is that you, Mother? This awful cold. It's so horrible. So painful. And so very, very real. Goodbye, old friend.
Dennis. Dennis, could you move away from the door? I have to pick up B.
Mum, I have a cold.
No, you want out of school, like when you said you had chicken pox. Or when you said you were pregnant. Or when you said your arm fell off. Unless you really have a cold, like your dad, don't waste my time.
Dad has a cold?
Yes, and apparently it's very infectious, so keep far, far away from him.
Hi, Dad! Calm down, Dad. I'm here to look after you. Bacon sandwich?
Oh, lovely, Dennis. How nice of you. What's in this sandwich?
Bacon, bread, tomato sauce. Hang on.
Oops.
Water? Right, need a plan B. What is it Gran says?
Hey, Dennis, you want to see me get a whole coconut into me mouth?
Ow. No, not that.
Keep out of the cold and wet or you will catch a cold, I bet. Now, watch me get this coconut into me mouth.
Oh, what?
Fast! Brilliant, Gnasher!
Huh?
Gnash. Come on, Gnasher.
Gnash, gnash, gnash!
What? I'm still fine? Oh, come on!
So, how will he be?
Ah, he's fine. Nothing broken.
Oh, are you sure? I definitely felt something snap. Maybe I should stay at home, rest the foot, get my strength back.
No, you won't need to miss a day of school.
What? What kind of a doctor are you? Bye, Face! Curly!
Hey, Dennis! You okay?
No, I'm not. Well, yes, I am. Back to school.
Great! Because we're all going to the beach.
What?
Yeah, as everyone has just gotten over their colds, the teachers thought we should have a day out.
Brilliant! I love school! This is going to be the best day ever!
Oh, dear. The Beano Town cold. Best get you home.
No, no, that sneeze was a fluke. Achoo! So was that one. Achoo! And that one. Mum, I'm well. Achoo! I feel great. Achoo! Honestly, Mum, I'm fine. I'm completely...
Oh, Dennis.
Thank you.
frog. Pepper, stat! Fake puke. Plastic or rubber? Plastic. Oh, yes! Goaty menace! Three large pepperonis, please. Deep filled, extra everything. Pizza's off. Huh? Walter? Where's good old Brenda?
Oh, good old Brenda will be absent for a few days. As a consequence, the headmaster has afforded me the opportunity to elevate nutritional standards at our beloved school.
Huh?
Pizza's off.
Two bits of lettuce and a broad bean.
I don't even like broad beans.
Who does, Curly?
Another pie crumb, anyone?
Look at us. Scavenging in school bags for scraps.
Ooh, breadstick. Old pencil.
Kids like us need real food. And if we gotta make with some serious menacing to get it, that's an added bonus.
So there I was, helping a family of hedgehogs across the Autobahn. But with my nutritionally balanced menu, pupils will benefit from an immediate improvement.
Do your worst, Bee.
Along with a 9% reduction in their tendency to be irritating, smelly little oiks.
Ew!
9%? You are clever, Walter.
Come, sir, observe. He threw up in my chef's hat, then he fired me.
And goodness knows who will get to do tomorrow's school lunch.
Hello, sir. My Auntie Beryl does catering.
Nutritious, delicious dinners?
Yeah, why not give her a call? Bye! Hello? Yes, this is Auntie Beryl's catering service. Let's go serve up some fun. Lovely! Who's for pizza? We're running out of mash.
Sir, those dinner ladies, they're imposters. It's Dennis.
What? Don't be so silly, Walter. It's his Auntie Beryl.
But, sir, look. One of them is a dog.
Oh, Walter. I'm so sorry, Mrs.
Nasha, Nasha, Nash?
Ah, yes. Mrs. Nasha, Nasha, Nash. Walter, lots of elderly ladies grow a few whiskers. Don't be so rude.
No!
Oh, seriously, I thought Walter's head was going to explode.
Hi, Auntie Beryl's catering here. Tomorrow's order is 6 bags of potatoes.
Oh, did you hear that, Paul? A family reunion.
40 packs of fish fingers, 50 large pies.
150 very large.
Make that 150 very large pies. And 227 sausages.
Nash.
Sorry, 228. Thank you.
Hello, this is Auntie Beryl's catering again. I'd like to change tomorrow's lunch order.
What? There's been a mistake.
No mistake, doll. 2 tons of ice cream in 1 unfeasibly giant scoop. Ta-da!
Excellent.
Hello?
Hello?
Auntie Beryl, I've just had today's lunch order. 2 tons of ice cream.
Ice cream? No, 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 no ice cream here. Not a single scoop.
I'm coming right over. And what's all this about? Half a ton of live lobsters?
My face? Diversion, if you please.
Hello. Have you met Paul the potato? He's having his nap.
Get off me!
There! Dennis! Please tell me we are not selling cans of raspberry rocket!
Yes!
That stuff's full of sugar! Kids go hyper!
Good hyper or bad hyper?
Disaster hyper!
Everyone, whatever you do, do not under any circumstances drink this!
Pieface, get rid of this stuff!
Okay, see ya.
Curly, I didn't order any of those things.
Okay, I'm back.
You get rid of it?
Yeah.
Where?
Oh, I dumped it in that big bin with a picture of a lobster on it.
Cool. Now, you what?
Sorry to trouble you again, Auntie Beryl, but the school food inspector has turned up. He wants to, what is it you want to do again?
Inspect the school food, obviously.
Everything is all right, isn't it?
Yes, everything's fine.
Curly, Nasha, you've got to delay this inspector guy. Okay. All we gotta do is calm everyone down and get rid of an army of hyper lobsters. Can't be that hard. Listen up, you lot! Everybody gotta chill! Right now! Or else!
Well, she's not our usual dinner lady, but...
Herbal tea. Brilliant, eh? Now... We just need to... Sorry, all gone.
And then there's Mrs. Nasher, Nasher, Nash. Lovely lady, but don't mention the beer. Golly, hello, Mrs. Creature.
Okay, plan D and G it is. Just change suck to blow. This ought to cool everyone down. Walter, disguise, rubbish. Timing, perfect.
Walter!
I can explain!
No, no, I can't.
Two lettuce leaves and a broad bean?
Next!
Great to have you back, Brenda.
Ha ha ha!
Nasha's brilliant at keeping our treehouse a pest-free zone.
Claudius!
Claudius! Oops, speaking of pests... What have you done with Claudius?
Your monkey Moggy attacked us.
Only because your mouldy mutt chased him up there. Out of my way, I'm coming in.
Into our treehouse? No way.
Just you try and stop me.
Man the defences, menaces! Safe from intruders. Result! As if we'd let Walter or anyone into our treehouse.
Best den in the history of Beano Town.
Best den in the history of the world.
Cool. Can I come and see it?
No, sorry.
No, not possible.
Menace's only zone. No can do.
Did you just say no to me?
Yep.
Don't worry, Angel Face. I've seen their den. It's rubbish. My new den is far cooler than theirs.
Really?
What new den?
Ta-da! Perfecto!
You're a genius, Walter!
An evil genius.
You're too kind. Took me all night to design these ownership papers for the treehouse. Nobody'll know they're fake.
Nobody. Except me.
Angel Face, hand over that document.
What's in it for me?
You want to get into Dennis's treehouse, don't you? Well, I can help you if you help me.
What do you need?
Plan D&G. Track Walter's den with our secret weapon.
Nash!
One menace that dog sled.
Ready to mush.
Nasha, you know what to do.
Nash! Nash!
This is going to be a bumpy...
I've got something to show you.
Huh?
Boost, Nasha! Boost!
Walters! So you've been leading us on a wild goose chase all over town?
Yep. Fun, wasn't it?
Oh, not really.
Ow! Oh, don't worry, Pieface. Walter said once you'd finally caught up with me, I could take you to his new den.
So, what are we waiting for?
Of course, I'll have to blindfold you. Don't want to spoil the surprise.
Oh, are we nearly there yet? I'm hungry.
Oh, we're here, all right.
Ah.
What? Welcome!
belongs to me. Go ask your dad.
The treehouse does belong to Walter.
He came earlier and showed us the property deeds.
The properly what?
Ownership papers, usually kept in Mayor Scrimp's office. They say the tree and the treehouse belong to Walter's family.
Walter owns the treehouse? That can't be right.
I guess we'll need a new hideout.
I know the perfect place.
Pieface, sitting in your dad's old pie boxes in his pie shop is not the perfect place.
Course it is. Close to home pies on tap. Perfect. Isn't that right, Paul?
What do you mean, no?
At least someone's happy.
We are menaces, and we are not letting Walter take our treehouse. We're taking it back. Nash! This is the treehouse. Walter's the pepper pot, me, Nasher, Curly, Pieface. We sneak in, dodge our own traps, and take back what's ours.
Oh, tasty plan, Denny.
We've been expecting you, Dennis.
Bring it on.
Walter, look, I'll pop down to the town hall first thing in the morning and get you a copy.
The town hall? No, well, I mean...
You mean those papers of yours are fake. The treehouse never belonged to you, Walter.
No, I mean, no need. I've gone off this place. You can keep your stupid treehouse.
The treehouse was way too easy to break into. We need an old mattress, a broken bicycle, and all the baked beans we can carry.
In the morning, thank you. I've had enough excitement for one night.
Walter, I'm coming in!
Now!
Old baked beans, Dennis!
Woohoo! It's good to be home.
Ash!
You think this is funny?
Oh, don't be mad, Walter. Your little plant people look much better now. Their haircuts were boring.
You're just jealous because the cress you've grown doesn't look anywhere near this good.
What? Why would we be growing cress?
Well, what did you do with those seeds Creature gave you last week?
What a lovely day.
Oh, dear. Well, As this cress-growing assignment is homework, due tomorrow, you menaces can all expect detention.
Nah, we eat detention like he eats pies.
Sometimes I eat pies in detention.
Oh, so detention this weekend won't bother you then? The weekend of the Beano Town Comic Convention? With a once-in-a-lifetime appearance by the creators of Vampire Chicken Squad. Bye-bye.
Dennis, what are we going to do? Vampire Chicken Squad is my favourite comic. I mean, chickens who are vampires. And they have a squad. I mean, it's the best idea ever.
Paul was going to get all his issues autographed.
We can't miss this convention. We have to talk to someone who knows about growing plants. And fast...
Who's Daddy's little darling, then? So, cress, you say? Huh, I do have cress seeds, of course, but I usually prefer my flora a little more exotic, like this Venus flytrap here. Ash! About I give you seeds for both. The principles are the same. To maximize growth, you'll need a hothouse like this. Also, I recommend talking to your plants. The little beauties respond favorably to a good chat. Uh-huh. Last but not least, you'll need some fully organic plant food. Thanks to my secret formula, Gwendolyn here reached this height in only 2 years.
2 years? We need to make the cress grow much, much faster. Time to rev up the Colonel's formula with some extra extreme growth spurt ingredients. Self-raising flour.
Jumping beans.
Raspberry rocket. Coffee.
Ow!
What's ow?
This pie is too hot to eat.
And, more raspberry rocket. If this concoction isn't rocket fuel for plant growth, I don't know what is. Right, seeds. Where are the seeds?
Uh-oh, Dennis! The heat from the pie has fused the cress seeds and the Venus flytrap seeds together.
Weird. Oh, well, let's plant them anyway. What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, no, I think this pie is past its best before date.
If comics have taught us anything, and comics have taught us most things, a dodgy pie is the perfect ingredient for menaced up super science. To the hot house!
Do you think it'll work, Dennis?
Oh, it has to, Curly. We can't miss that comic convention.
Is our homework done?
Fingers and green thumbs crossed. We need this weekend to be detention-free.
Don't forget your promise to mow the lawn tomorrow, Dennis.
No, but tomorrow's the Beano Town Comic Convention.
Which can wait until you've mown the lawn.
Don't worry, Dennis. Hey, Pieface and I can help you mow it after school. Is it too late to take that back?
Was the grass this tall yesterday?
I don't know. I was too busy spilling our super plant food everywhere to notice.
Results!
I have to say, your plant's growth has surpassed all expectations.
Clearly they've cheated, miss. Yesterday they said they didn't even have seeds.
I don't remember saying that. Do you?
No.
Oh, it doesn't even look like proper cress. Those leaves have teeth.
Ah, that must be the Venus flytrap genes.
This is what perfect cress looks like. Who's ever seen cress that big?
Don't you know anything, Walter? This is what big cress looks like. When they're grown up, cress heads have actual teeth.
Oh, fascinating. See, even a teacher can learn something new at school. Now, don't be jealous, Walter. I'm giving all three of these boys the top mark.
Sorry, Walter.
Oh, I know you haven't done this homework, Minnis. And the moment I can prove it, that top mark will be mine.
and you'll all be on Comic Convention Missing Detention.
Walter can't prove a thing.
Yes! We dodged detention the one weekend when dodging detention matters.
Dennis! The unusually large and bitey cress. It's got larger and biteier.
There may still be a bit more dodging to do.
I told you it's not Craig. You don't see Craig this big and eating things.
Dennis?
Walter's absolutely right. You don't see Craig this big and eating things. And that's because, this is how fully grown cress carries on. Kids normally grow cress for a week and then eat it. What most kids don't know is they have to eat it or it'll grow up and eat them. Sorry, miss. Our cress got this big because we were so eager to do the homework. We planted it too soon.
Well, that makes perfect sense.
What? No, it doesn't!
As you can see, the preferred food of the fully grown cress is pies.
It must be my pie in the plant food. We've created a Venus pie trap.
Miss Creature, as fully grown cress experts, we can contain the situation, but we will need to leave school early.
Fine, whatever you need.
Emergency, Brenda. We need every pie you can muster.
What now, Dennis?
The Colonel said we should talk to our plants, so let's talk. Oi, plants! Pies!
I hope you've got a plan, Dennis. We're running out of pies.
What? I only had one or two.
Don't worry, Curly. Genius always has a plan. They'll be happy here. Disposing of pies past the sell-by date.
Dad's best shop assistant ever. Nice one, Dennis.
Okay, mutant crest dealt with. All we have to do now is deal with that lawn. Gang, rustle up a mowing device and meet me at my place. Where did you get a goat?
From the goat convention.
There's a goat convention?
Yeah, at the convention centre. Today's the last day. Tomorrow's the comic convention.
Ah, which we're not gonna miss. Let's get mowing! Well, it's a good job we also have national power.
It's growing faster than we can mow it.
All this mowing is disturbing my study. Why is it taking so long?
We're being thorough.
Thorough? With a chore? Now, why does that strike me as suspicious?
No, nothing suspicious going on here, Walter. Just lawn mowing.
I've got my eye on you, Minises.
Phew. If Walter realises the grass is growing out of control, he'll tell Creature that we didn't do the cress homework properly.
Oh, but at this rate, we'll be mowing the lawn all weekend.
We'll never get to the comic convention.
Pieface, where there's a convention, there's a way.
So the goat convention's finished then?
Uh-huh. To make way for the comic convention, which we'll be at.
But how do we get rid of all these goats?
One problem at a time, Pieface. One problem at a time.
Headmaster.
No, it wasn't me.
Detention!
Sorry, but we just can't do this detention. Places to go, people to menace.
Well, you should have thought of that earlier, shouldn't you, Dennis?
Please, Mrs. Creature. It'll clear in a few hours. I promise I'll make it up to you.
You'll make it up to me by writing 1,000 times, I will not make stink bombs ever again.
Oh, this is bad. Really bad. Oh, what's wrong, Dennis? We've done loads of detentions.
Yeah, and it's not that long a sentence.
Yeah, but Mayor Scrimp's unveiling his new statue at 5 o'clock. Time for some menacing genius. I have to be there. 3:30. Better get a code 1 menace alert to Nasha to help spring us.
A code 1?
Trust me, it'll be worth it. Okay. Time for Plan B.
What about the torturing teacher over there?
This calls for a 40 wink blink think to get us out of the clink. And I know just the think. I mean thing. And the key for the ref is to make sure the last defender is in line. Offside rule nap attack. Works every time.
Real curly. Now, let's bust out of here, find Nasha, and leg it to the park.
Another faulty ball. I must have a word with the manufacturers.
Okay. Plan C. Aha! The confiscation cupboard. Should be one or two useful things of mine in there.
Phew, that was close.
Ooh. Now, who's good at tying knots?
No, 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 Dudley. You've got it all wrong. It was Mahler's 7th symphony that was in E minor.
What the?
Well, well, well. I wonder what the headmaster would say if he saw this. Let's find out, shall we?
Real plan, Dennis. Just enough time to get a quick bite of pie.
No can do. We've got to get to the park before 5.
Dennis.
Sir, this is just the kind of irresponsible behaviour I've come to expect from these rapscallions.
What? You snitch, Walter!
What he means is we were just checking that the emergency escape routes are working, you know, in case of an emergency. Yep, no, that all seems to be fine.
Oh, please! You're not going to fall for that, are you, Headmaster?
What? Oh, no, of course not. I wasn't born yesterday.
Oh, of course you weren't. You're much, much, much older than that.
It's better if I keep an eye on them from now on. I already know the offside rule.
Are you sure, Headmaster?
Yes, yes, don't worry. I've recruited a little extra help.
Jump to it, men! I want those prisoners contained, whatever it takes.
He's been listening to too many of the Colonel's war stories.
Walter's not the only one we have to get past.
No worries. Headmaster, have you met Paul the Potato? Paul thinks you are feeling very sleepy.
Oh, I see what you're doing. Well, you won't catch me. I mean...
Well done, Pie Face. You too, Paul. Right, You thinking what I'm thinking?
Oh, definitely. Brilliant, Dennis. Genius, yeah. No, sorry, no idea.
It's finally time for Plan D. Cover me, men. I'm going in.
They're coming! Stand by to repel!
Fire, sir!
Charge! Call that a water pistol. This is a water pistol.
Okay, so they have the doors and the windows covered. But we haven't tried going down.
No one under here. Just nice.
Further, I'm starving.
By my calculations, we should be underneath the perimeter fence around about next Tuesday.
Well, that's no good, Curly. Got to be there by 5 o'clock or we'll miss everything.
What's that noise?
My stomach?
Nope, I'd know that sound anywhere. Brilliant, Nasha! I knew you'd get here. Eventually.
Nasha got in. We can go out the same way.
And that's Plan D and G. We'll get to the park if we double quick crawl. Lead the way, Pie Face.
Oh, sorry, Dennis. Must have been the pies at lunch.
We'll have to make the tunnel a lot bigger.
Nasha will sort it out. Fantastic! We'll be in the park in time.
Keep it up, men. Those prisoners are slippery. Could pop up anywhere.
Free? At last?
Not on my watch.
Like I said, I'm not the kind of fool to let myself be hypnotized.
Ah, sorry, Dennis. It's 4:30. I think it's game over.
Game what?
Over.
No way! We're Team Menace. We never give up.
Evening, ladies.
Good night, young man.
All right, remember our guard's motto. Be prepared for anything. Those prisoners could make a break for it at any moment.
Doing here, boys? Detention finished 30 minutes ago.
What?
Do tell Walter he can go. Poor boy will be guarding you all night otherwise. What about Walter?
Oh, we'll let him know eventually. Come on! And it gives me great pleasure to my statue. I don't know much about art, Nasha, but I know what I like.
Nash, Nash, Nana, Nash.
Only a few more hours to go.
Time to go to Plan L.
Plan L?
Leggings!
Didn't see you there, Dennis. Oh, wait. Yes, I did.
Oh, you're toast, Walter!
Oi, you!
This week, miss.
It's Monday, and you've been late every day this term. The rest of you aren't much better either, except for you, Walter, 100%.
Perhaps people would make more effort if there was a proper punishment for being late, miss.
Aww. You're right, Walter. Anyone late for school this week won't be going to Beano Town Fair. Aha! Quiet!
Make Walter late for school.
How? He's never been late for anything in his life.
There's no way Dennis is coming on that trip. Whatever it takes, I'm going to make him late for school.
Isn't he always late for school anyway?
Shut up, Bertie.
Shutting up, Walter. Yeah.
I think I may have
an idea.
Dennis, and somebody ought to move that brick.
Stop his car?
There's no other way. You got a better idea?
What do you think, Pie-face?
Look, I glued Paul so he could have a swing.
Cool. And, how are you going to get him off again?
Easy, I'll just put... Paul, what have I done?
Huh? He won't fall for the window trick again. We need to think of something new.
Right. Think, think, think.
Think, think, think.
Aha! I have it.
Somebody ought to move that brick.
Thank you.
emergency, Father! Send it immediately!
Hey? Huh?
Father's company chopper! Doesn't your dad have one?
Masha! Shore power!
Time to enlist an old school menace.
Punctuality is so important, don't you think, miss? Unless you're Dennis, of course.
Phew! Thanks, Gran. Morning, miss.
Will someone please move that brick?
Excellent helicopter manoeuvre, Walter.
You're such a clever Stokes.
I know I am. Unfortunately, Mrs. Creature has banned me from using the helicopter again. But no matter. With this transmitter, I'm going to know all Dennis's pranks in advance. Pie face! How's, potato thingy?
Oh, he's still quite sore.
Oh, dear. Maybe this will help.
Wow, thanks, Walter. He wants to say thank you himself. Go on, Paul, don't be shy.
We need to find something to distract him. What does Walter really care about?
Guys, I think Paul's going to make it.
That's it! Walter loves his pet cat. So what I'm thinking is... No way will Walter leave for school if he thinks Claudius is missing. Cat biscuits, Nasha?
Nash, Nash, Nash!
I've got you this time, Dennis the Menace.
Ha-ha!
Brilliant! Claudius has taken the biscuit bait. Once again, genius wears a striped jumper. Nasha?
Oh, thanks, Dennis. Claudius loves these. Don't be too late for school. Sasha!
Last one, hey, Nasha?
Oi!
Get him, Nasha!
Nasha, 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 Nasha!
Not bad for a morning's menacing. Look on the bright side, miss. We're not late for school.
Dennis! All right, class. You have 5 minutes to finish today's experiment.
With my personal junior genius lab kit, that should present no problem, Mrs. Creature.
Mrs. Creature, my beaker's broken.
Look.
Oh, yeah. Oh, then pair up with Walter, Dennis.
What?
Oh, surely you two can work together for 5 minutes.
Doc!
We've had to evacuate the entire school because of the smell. Do you have anything to say for yourselves for ruining Mrs. Creature's experiment?
Yes, Headmaster. It was all his fault.
I told you not to touch the beaker when the liquid oozes. You have zero understanding of slime production.
What's there to understand? Puerile pranks, tawdry tricks, all child's play.
Child's play? Menacing takes skill and precision timing. You couldn't menace a dead fish.
I could do that in my sleep, whereas you wouldn't last one afternoon completing my to-do list.
What, measuring the straightness of my tie with a ruler? Yeah, really hard, Walter.
I do more than that.
Boys, it seems we have here a classic lack of mutual understanding. But I have the perfect solution. You will each spend this afternoon living each other's lives. I've spoken to your parents and it's agreed. This afternoon you will live according to the habits and rules of the other's household. Stop! Swap!
I'll explain later, Nasha. It's complicated.
Here is Walter's jam-packed schedule for this afternoon.
Jingle Composer Club. Toothpick Modeler's Symposium with the Colonel. Competitive bird watching. Swimming pool mathletics. Pet grooming. Where do you keep your garden shears?
Dennis's schedule? For what?
His after-school activities.
He doesn't exactly have a schedule. He lives in the moment.
This will be a breeze, just as I thought. I do hope Dennis is coping. I hope you've studied your chords. Stand straight, shoulders back. No slouching! Now, after me, I'll count us in. One, two, three, four.
Usually Dennis just says something like, rock!
Rock?
Don't mind if I do!
Bird watching? Yeah. Let's liven this up, Nasha.
Snake! Yeah, this isn't the sort of thing we do with Dennis, Walter.
But that is.
Ta-da!
So, this is a toothpick modeler's symposium.
Play with B can't be that hard.
Oh, I don't know how much more of this I can take. What's swimming pool mathletics anyway?
3 times 7 is 21. 4 times 7 is 28.
5 times 7, Dennis. Oh, I know this one. Cannonball!
So far, you're not doing very well at being Walter, Dennis.
I knew you'd find my life too hard. Meanwhile, I'm blitzing yours. Treehouse tidied, a study regime for B. I've even introduced the din makers to the principles of classical harmony.
That's not being a menace, Walter. That sounds like things you do. Epic fail.
Boys, you have one more chance to live each other's life before the day is done, or I'll pair you up in every class until the term ends.
17 times 32 is 544. 18 times 32 is 576.
19 times 32 is...
Okay, time for plan D, G and W. We need to help each other if we're going to get through to Tester's experiment.
Very well. Listen carefully. After swimming pool mathletics, it's bath time. Make sure you use plenty of soap. Then it's afternoon tea. This is very important. You must use the scone fork. It's second from the right. Do not use the Battenberg fork.
Okay, but Walter, you've got to think like a menace. Remember, fun is always just around the corner.
Come, Claudius. We have menacing to attend to.
And it's bath time for you and me. Lots of soap, eh? Low setting, I think.
Right, let's get you kitted out with some menacing equipment. Ooh. Ooh.
Right, Nasha. All I have to do is get through the scone test and life goes back to normal.
Yes!
He certainly looks and smells the part.
Not the Battenberg fork! Use the second one! The second one!
Just goes to show you can complete a successful experiment without any mischief. A plus for you, Dennis.
Yes!
But Walter still has to pass his test.
Walter excels at everything he does. He'll be just fine, I assure you.
I'm not so sure about that. Come on, Nasha.
Where are the instructions on this device?
Too late anyway. Postman's way out of range now.
Strangely quiet today.
Oh, no!
I told you not to waste time arranging the pranks according to the Dewey Decimal System.
But they needed sorting out. I failed.
Maybe not.
No! I couldn't possibly.
Ha-ha! But I could.
Yes, yes.
Do it, Claudius.
Walter! What are you doing, Walter?
Being Dennis, sir.
Yes, I suppose you are. Well done. Very good. So, what have you learnt today, Walter?
Well, that having no rules can be somewhat liberating.
And you, Dennis?
Ah, well, I learnt that, that everyone needs a bath sometimes.
Yes, I suppose they do. Congratulations, boys. You have successfully completed today's experiment.
Would you care to join us for afternoon tea, Headmaster?
Thank you, Walter. I never say no to a scone.
Whoa! Who knew bath time could be so much fun? Follow me.